Welcome back. You're watching Sports This Morning, broadcasting live from our sports center in Lagos, Nigeria. Do you want to be part of the show? Yes, you can. You can talk to us. We don't want you to just watch this show. Come, let us play for the love of the game on Twitter, channels underscore sports, Facebook, Channel Life in Sports. You can send us an email to sportsthismorning@channelstv.com. We're talking about the 2016 Rio Olympics. We're beginning to feel the fever. It's just 14 more days to go. Are you getting ready? How prepared is Team Nigeria? We're talking about the Nigerian spirit. Nigerian spirit would advise Shayo Ogunlewe, if you see it passing, jump on the bus, follow it. We'll get to know when the games actually begin in Rio. For Brazil, they're getting ready, they're putting finishing touches, they are not smiling with security. They believe it's very, very important, and they're giving it all the attention that it can get. They are also branding. You saw recycled materials put together to form a beautiful ring on the beach of Rio de Janeiro. So with that, they are getting ready. Talk to us using the hashtag Rio Olympics. Paul Pogba. We stop talking about Paul Pogba until the season starts. Yes, and that's if Jose Mourinho wants us to stop, because he's not talking much about the dude anymore, but we know, we believe, we feel the body language that he wants Paul Pogba. Maybe Jose might just be signing Paul Pogba. Talk to us in the hashtag Pogba. Let's know what makes him so thick of a player that everyone is talking about him now, particularly Jose Mourinho. He wants him in his squad. And we advise Jose, look, if Paul Pogba is not coming, there's John Mikel Obi. Yeah, you can sign him, take him to Manchester United. Let's also talk about Nigeria's football team, the national under-23 team. The update is that Coach Samson Siasia submitted a list of 22 players to FIFA. We will try to look at that list. We know there's John Mikel Obi there. That's a senior player right there. There's also Daniel Akpen. You know some of the names. Etebo is also in the list. We will discuss this list. Guys, let's quickly take a look at this list. The goalkeepers, we know Daniel Akpen. Emmanuel Daniel was with the under-23 team. Cecilia, there was a time you said it was shaky, but Sam Cecilia says he's still believing in him for the games.
Yeah, I think so.
Now, that's Emmanuel Daniel, right? But there's a reason why he's brought in Daniel Akpen, who I believe is going to be the first choice for the tournament. Daniel Akpen, more experienced, plays with Chippa United in South African Premier League. He's a very good goalkeeper. So, I think we're covered in that particular position.
Okay, and if you look at the defenders, you have Mwen Francis here, Kingsley Mando, Abdullahi Sheu, Saturday Erimoya, William Trust Ekong, you have Ndi Preke Udo, Stalin Amuzie.
Surprise.
William Trust Ekong is there as well, too. Good defender. And the forwards,
you have Aminu Umar, Imo Ezekiel, Oluwafemi Ajayi, and Sadiq Umar.
Sadiq Umar plays for AS Roma.
That's right.
Very well. Decent striker. So, yeah, the midfielders.
You have Ogene Karu, Etebo, of course, expected. Jomi Kelobit, Pokwola Saliu. Okay, Chukwu Azubuike, of course, I expected him to be there. Usman Mohamed also there. Then you have the players, man, in case anyone get injured, any of these ones can actually be pulled up. But I'm surprised they have Taiwo Awoniyi, you know, and his Godwin Savior. You know, these guys are the players that are on standby. Then the goalkeeper on standby is Yusuf Bala.
Yeah, I mean, the coach is paid to make this kind of decisions. Right. And it feels Taiwo Awoniyi, Savior Godwin should be on the standby list.
That's right.
But, you know, first glance at this list, I know Cecilia is waiting for this because she's always been against, you know, calling this a dream team. This is far from a dream team. Far from a dream team, because the origin of a dream team is basically an all-star squad where you have the absolute best in goal, from goalkeeper to striker. That's not the case here, Cecilia, right?
I'm looking at players. I mean, Cecilia get paid to do this, so I would just look at the players and see. Maybe he feels these are the players that can actually work well for him. And, you know, I listened to him when he was talking on Sports Tonight yesterday. He said something like, you know, if these big players are not ready to play, I mean, he had to choose the ones that will play. I was expecting to see, you know, we talked about some key players we wanted to see on this list. Odoyingalo, you know,
even Isaac
Success and some other players on that.
Fernando Addis said he would like to also play there
and everything. But you really can't, you know, give what you don't have. If players are not willing to play for a country, they're not actually willing to make that sacrifice, then there's nothing absolutely you can do.
I don't think
so. He feels these are the players players are actually. That's the thing, because some of these players, their clubs are not releasing them.
Exactly.
So and they're like, okay, I can't tell my coach, look, I have to play for my country. You may come back at the end of the day, you wouldn't have the shirt. You know, you lose your shirt and all that. So they don't want to do that.
They don't make that sacrifice.
They don't want to make that sacrifice. So that's the way it works. And if you feel your club is, you know, paying the bills. And you know, no, your club career is higher and bigger, you know, than your country. So most of them will just make the decision. I mean, make, okay, I'd rather play for my club at this time and ensure that I have a permanent shirt than having coming to play for
Sicily,
a tournament.
The players
like
are in a very difficult situation. Right. You know, they're not just gonna disappear, pack their bags, and go against the wishes of the clubs. If the clubs don't release them, they don't go anywhere. It's as simple as that. It's very clear cut. Yeah. That's why you see other federations, talking to these clubs, ensuring some certain players are released. Yeah. In the case of Neymar, he was released for the Olympics, but he didn't go to play at the Copa America, and several other players like that. So,
but clubs should stop putting players in that situation where they need to make a
choose
decision.
Between
in 2008, Messi, Messi told Barca, look, I got good, I want to play at the Olympics.
At the time, that's Messi. Just Messi's like Neymar now, at the time, that was you just mentioned 2008. Right now, Messi is not with the Argentine squad. He's not even playing. I mean,
we're
still waiting for retirement and all that.
But when it gets to the point where
that's what he's saying. I mean, quitting national team.
The call to national duty should be
very it's interesting to know that Mexico also struggling with that. Some of their big players are not playing. Colombia also, their big players are saying they're not playing. So Mexico practically had to build the players around the ones they feel they can get. And Mexico happens to be defending champion, right?
That's why
Colombia also.
Brazil wants it. All the big players are ready.
Because they're hosting, it's different. Brazil is actually hosting, so any player will definitely want to play. They're hosting and they want, and they've never won it before.
The federations have done the proper thing to do. They've been able to secure the release of those players. Douglas Costa, Neymar, and the likes have been released for Brazil. So I don't think it's about the club alone. It would be unfair to just say the clubs are putting the players in a difficult situation.
I think the clubs are doing that because
they pay the bills and they can decide, you know, what player stays back and which players, you know, goes for a particular tournament.
I'm trying to agree with you and Cecilia that we shouldn't call this team the dream.
It's not
team.
A dream team.
But can they dream when you look at it?
Of course,
team.
They can dream.
They can dream. That's where I want us. That's the positive I want us to get out of this, because at this stage it's on the 23 level. And we don't know, it's not a senior men's national team. So when you're playing Sweden, don't shake. When you're playing Japan, don't be afraid. Because when you look at it, let's start with the defenders. Okay. Even for goalkeeper, Daniel Akpeyo has got good experience with the senior men's national team. Let's look at Kingsley Madu. He has some good experience with the senior men's national team. There's also Abdoulaye Sheu, who is a good utility player. Yeah. William Troost-Ekong, he keeps getting better as a defender. Stanley Amuzie, didn't give Cecilia the sort of play that Cecilia expects, but you can bank on that kind of experience. So when you look at it, how many of these guys do we not really know about that can go to the world stage and play good football? Come to the forwards. There's Aminu Umar. Imo Ezekiel has been in this country's radar for almost forever.
Yeah, but he still hasn't proved himself.
But he has a chance now.
He's got a chance.
Yeah, so he needs to take it.
What kind of football does he play in Qatar?
When Aaron Stammer was discovered in China, what sort of football do you expect him to play? You just need to know you're a professional. Yeah. This is a call to national duty, so you need to give your best.
I'm not saying he doesn't have the ability or the quality. What I'm saying is that exactly emphasizes my point about it not being a dream team, because when you talk about a dream team, you're talking of players, the absolute best. So let's just drop that nickname now.
Exactly. I've dropped it long ago. If they
I'm
go
not
to Brazil.
Up on this team.
To the midfielders. Austin, you don't get our point. We're not saying these are not good players. We didn't say that. We say, okay, these are the players that can do the job for Samson Siasia. The reason I'm talking about the dream team is dream team came about in Atlanta 96 because they actually won the gold medal. That's how the name came about. I mean, they were calling them the dream team. What we're saying is, if a team is able to win, I mean, you call them the dream team. And even when if they're not superstar right now, after winning, they become superstars, right? Let's wait for them to win that gold we're talking about. So what we can bring it back, dream team. It's not dream team. It's just a team.
Dreaming team.
Thank you.
Because
dreaming team. And when they win, they become the dream team.
The USA basketball team.
Thank you. Tell him.
That wants to dominate. Barcelona, the Olympics, Barcelona 92. There was a reason, because they had all the best NBA players there.
In that sport.
I want to put it into the hands of our viewers. I'm taking a look at our
players also in that Atlanta 96. Start with Kanu Nwankwo and all the top players we had. And these players were actually some of them just won a Champions League with some of their clubs and everything. So that was the difference. But these players were looking at it. You're asking me, well,
a lot of unknown quantities.
Oh, come on. It's okay. Yeah, you will know them when they win. No one knew Kenneth Omeru when was taking him to South Africa. No one knew Godfrey Obuabona, Sunday Mba, Azubike Gwekwe.
Nobody knew that.
Same thing, a coach believes in this player.
Yeah, there's no debate about that. We're just dropping the name.
Is it a dream team? I'm taking it away from Tyre and Cecilia. Let's put it in your hands. Is it a dream team? You've seen the list that Coach Samson Siasia has submitted. I believe there's quality in that team. Well, even if we cannot call them the dream team yet, do you think this team can dream? Can they impress at the games in Rio? Talk to us. Twitter channels _ sports. Facebook channels IFM Sports. It is your comments. It's your opinion that I want to read on the program this morning. I'm taking my guys out on this one because... yeah, it's okay. Let's look at the team properly. We don't know most of the names that are there, but some of the names, they have good senior team experience. And that might just count for something when they start their campaign, the football campaign in Brazil. Tyre, Cecilia, and that's the message. That's what I'm trying to say. All we need to do now is believe in this team.
Of course, yeah, we're believing in them, and hopefully they can actually do us. But we're not saying we won't believe in it. We're believing in this team. They can do us proud. And when they get to win, that's what we're looking for. We call them the dream team. I'm just saying, a team will have to be a dream team when you have superstar. Not just that, when you get to win. And we made reference to Atlanta 96. I think they're all good players, fantastic players. Samson Siasia definitely wants to go ahead and see what he can do with this particular squad. And hopefully we can get something out of Rio. We don't want to talk about their preparations right now. We know it's some nonsense. Let's look at that group again.
You know, with Nigeria, Colombia, Japan, and Sweden.
Yeah.
No, it's not a gimme.
I will go to bed, Tyus.
They'll come out of that group.
I will go to bed. Nigeria will come out of it anytime. Come on, look at the players we'll take it to the competition. Who do we know at that level?
I wonder where you're Japan, with Sweden.
Because I'm a Nigerian, I understand that Coach Samson says is the most adventurous coach that we've ever had in this country. He can take a risk, push somebody out there and say, play your game, and they'll be fine, and they will get you the result.
Adventure's not enough for you to...
These guys are professional footballers. By the time they get into that field, guys, you will be shocked at what they will do. Nigeria will come out of Group B very well. We'll top Group B. Say I said so even before the competition started. 14 days before the competition started, I said Nigeria will come out of Group B. Austin has spoken. That's what it is. Let's come to Twitter now. Modi McBenna, thank you so much for dropping by. My take is that Siasia does not even know his squad. Who told you that? He keeps changing and swapping them. It's not the best.
It's not him.
Why do you use the hashtag dream team? Well, that's what it is. At this level, you look at a player, you're not comfortable, you say, hey, come here, bring another player, you just experiment.
It wasn't really that. You know, I told you I listened to him on Sportsnet yesterday. Talked about players were just pulling out. They didn't want... So it wasn't about him. It was about the players that were available to him, left for him. There are some key players he wanted in this squad, but these players were pulling out. So what can he do?
That's the thing. It's just the one he had.
So that's what is going with. So you just wouldn't have to say, hey... It's not like that at all. That's not him.
Okay. More reactions. He's talking about Pogba. I want you to talk about the national under 23 team. As this one is wishing Siasia all the best with the team. They can actually dream. Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Yeah, even if they're not a dream team, they can actually dream. And with that, yes, Tyo, that's the confidence they need to take. That's the optimism they need to go into this competition. I say to themselves, Tyo, Cecilia, and some other football fans believe we're not yet a dream team.
They're not a dream team. Stop saying it. Come on.
They're just not a dream team.
That's fact. It's not like, hey, we're saying, no, they're not a dream team. They're just Nigeria's on the 23 national team.
That's all.
You stay there.
That's all.
Yeah.
That's where it stops.
Thank you.
Yeah. Modi McBernard again. He says, I only deserves a place in that main team, if not for anything, but for the experience he has gotten over time. Well, the coach knows better.
Yeah.
We can only just talk about it. He knows what. So maybe... it just needs stay. I understand by list might just be the motivation he will need. The next time he gets a chance, kick the ball, he will give his best. So that's it with Taiwan Oni But guys, when you look at the list, I'll go back to that.
To
list.
The forwards again. Yeah. There's one, Oluwafemi Ajayi. Mm. Yeah, that's Junior Ajayi.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a decent
forward. Yeah, of course. Decent we know. Yeah.
We'll keep talking about this. You know what? Let's go on a quick break. Well, God, we need to take a breather. These guys are not smiling with the dream team. When we come back, we'll continue our look at what's going down in your exciting world of sports. Don't go anywhere. Stay.